Yeah. Next. Now, supply of services by government entity. The earlier entry was government. This is government entity. What is the difference between government and government entity? So, government is government, central government, state government. Government entity means entity formed by government. Like MTNL is a government entity, BSNL is a government entity, ONGC is a government entity. So, government company, so services provided by government company to government companies also exempt under this entry. Yeah, government entity. Next. This was not there earlier in old law, therefore this entry is not there in your model. So latest entry, you can see here we are having one home and there are two old people are there. Okay, so government is trying to provide, you know, some kind of security to old people in our nation now, and therefore government or some charitable organization, not only government, some charitable organizations are also running old age home. Old age home means when you are fed up with your parents, you can put them into old age home. Yes or no? Because you are unable to look after them. You are busy in your own life. Nothing wrong about it. If you put them in old age home, obviously they will charge some consideration from you. It's like they are not going to keep them for free and feed them for free. Some consideration they will charge. These people are saying, GST people are saying, if that consideration is up to means, up to, is not less than 25,000. Its consideration is up to 25,000 per month per member, then it is exempt. Are you getting this? Up to 25,000 per, see, look at this language. Services provided by an old age home, run by whom? Central government or state government, or an entity registered under section 12AA, that is charitable trust, okay, to its resident, and the people should be old age, no, old means 60 plus, 60 years or more, against consideration up to 25,000 rupees per month per member. So if your mother and father are there, both are 20,000 exempt. Are you getting this? Up to 20,000 per month, provided that consideration charge is inclusive of charges for boarding, lodging and maintenance. So it is inclusive of everything. Am I clear? Now, whenever exemption is written in up to language, please understand, whenever exemption is written in up to language, if the charges are 27,000, hello, if charges are, only 2,000 will become taxable, because exemption is up to, they did not say the consideration should not exceed, does not exceed 25,000. So that's another language. So this is not a condition, this is not a condition, this is a limit, this is the limit. And whenever I say limit, please understand, limit means up to 25,000 it is exempt. That means more than 25,000 only excess will become taxable. But this was not a case in the temple and all. Hello? Temple and all, their language was consideration should be less than 10,000. Hello? Kalyana Mandapam, religious center. If you want exemption, it should be less than 10,000. If it is 10,000 or more, fully taxable. That was the condition. This is the limit. Am I clear? Yeah. So that is the legal understanding you should develop gradually. These examples will come again and again. Okay. So here only excess will become taxable. If it is 30,000, only 5,000 will become taxable. Next. Services supplied by central government, state government, union territory to public sector banking, PSUs, you know, public sector undertaking and public sector bank. So it is government to public sector undertaking or public sector banks, not taxable, exempt, not that important. Okay, every time we should not be spending much of time. Now, if you have to run hospital, you need to take registration from government. Hello? If you wanted to run hotel, you need to take food registration from government. If you are going to manufacture chemicals, you need to take clearance, environmental clearance from government. So we as a business entity, we take lot of registration and license from government. Yes or no? If I have to incorporate company, I have to pay ROC fee. Yes or no? All right. So those are fees for registration and licensing is a service provided by government to business entity. Yes or no? Yes. Do you want it to become costlier in India? No. So we are not putting GST on it. Although it is services provided by government to business entity, but if it is in registration form, hello, registration under any law or testing, calibration, safety check, Are you getting this? Fire safety and all, they will come and check. Alright. So all those is exempt. Okay. Can I go ahead? Yes. Next. Alright. Whenever I come to this particular point, I always say, okay, there are two certificates which will be given by government for sure. Two certificates you will get from government for sure. Without doing anything. That is birth certificate, death certificate. Balance all certificate in this period is your achievements. Hello? And that depends on you. No limits. Whatever certificate you wanted to earn, I bless you guys, you should get those certificate. Okay? But you should deserve that certificate first. Okay? So birth certificate and death certificate is not freely available. We have to pay some money to get that certificate. Okay? Passport, driving license, visa, everything. Okay? We need to pay money, but it is not taxable. It is exempt. Clarificatory in nature. These are exempt. Okay? Sometime what happens, I take contract from government to construct bridge or road. Yes or no?
Yes.
And then I don't perform that contract or I delay the contract. Whenever I delay the contract, government is going to put some penalty on me. Penalty for what, sir? Penalty for tolerating non-performance. Penalty for tolerating? Kuch nahi kiya, time pe nahi kiya. And they are tolerating it. So it's a service. Tolerance is a service. Yes or no? So they are going to put 5 crore penalty on me now because I did not deliver project on time. They gave me contract of 1000 crore to construct one highway. I did not deliver it on time. I delayed it. Okay. Because I delayed it, they are going to put 5 crore rupees penalty on me. Hello? And I have to pay that penalty. I paid that penalty. How bad it would be if government say pay 18% extra as a GST. Already I know how I managed that particular 5 crore rupees. Now government is taking 18% extra, will be like harassment to me. Yes or no? They are putting penalty along with GST. Alright. So government said no. Whenever we are going to take any penalty from you for tolerating your non-performance, it is exempt. It is exempt. Next. Next. Some services provided to farmer. Okay. Assignment of rights. So some government open land is there. Government owned land, okay, and government is giving that right to farmer. Okay, you come here, you pay us a royalty fees, you take this land and run this land for 10 years, 15 years, whatever is the time period given to you for cultivation purpose. Okay, so that is also exempt. Services given by government as an assignment of right to use natural resources to an individual farmer for cultivation, so that is exempt. Very specific. Okay. Next entry number 65. Entry number 65 is like Diwali just happened in Mumbai. Okay. You have ordered some crackers from China. Okay. And you can see this is India and your vessel is about to come. This is your vessel which is coming. Okay. But it is expected that it will take another 5 to 6 hours to reach Indian port. Okay. And this is 5 o'clock and from tomorrow Diwali holiday will start. So custom department will also go on holiday and still this is the 5 o'clock and the vessel will still take 5 to 6 hours to reach. Hello? This means custom people are saying, okay, now you come for clearance after Diwali. You are telling them, sir, you don't understand, I have ordered crackers. If I don't get that consignment before Diwali, then I'm into losses. I have to commit suicide. I will die here only. Okay. So you are requesting custom people, please stop, sir. Please stop for another 5-6 hours. Please wait. And for that, if you need any extra money, I will pay you extra money. Now, either it is official or unofficial, but I will pay extra money. So there is a provision in custom law where custom officer can even work on Sundays, on holidays, or even thereafter official ask to clear the consignment, but then they will charge merchant overtime charges. Already you are paying merchant overtime charges which is above your fees. Yes or no? If they ask along with GST, then you will get so frustrated. Already you are paying 1 lakh rupees extra and if they say okay 18% more you have to pay. So that's a torture kind of thing. So we are saying okay, merchant overcharges are exempt in law. Okay. So this is another point. Then there is a one more amendment taken place, not that important. There is some body called excess royalty collection collector. That body services are exempt. Okay. Next, rehab. Now in your module I saw one or two question which has been asked or which were framed before section, before entry number 74A. This is latest entry. Before this entry, rehab services were taxable. Do you understand rehab services? You are addicted to alcohol, drugs, or some other narcotics substance, okay, or you are mental lunatic, okay. Don't look at me, please. All right, so government have created some hospitals, some places where you can go and take this rehab services which is away from your family, and then there are people who are trained to look after you. Hello. And then you may get cured. Very rare chances, but there is a possibility at least. At least the impact of that craziness will go down. Yes. Hello. So those rehab center, it's not a hospital type of services. It's not a hospital kind of, but this is also important. No, see, usually hospital provide physical health services. This is mental health services. So don't you think even mental health is important?
Yes.
So government took time to understand. Even in 2019 they exempted it. Hello. They took 2-3 years time to understand even rehab centers are important, but services provided by rehabilitation professionals recognized under, but it's not private sector. It should be recognized under Rehabilitation Council of India Act. And what service they are providing? Rehabilitation therapies, counseling. You understand counseling? Yeah. And such other activity as covered by said act, but it has to be covered by that said act. At medical establishment, that means in hospitals, mental hospitals and all. Sometimes it is not in mental hospital, it might be just a psychological professor. You know, you just have to, you are going through some pain, emotional pain, you just have to go to professor and talk to him. That professor will handle your matter. So you may go to some educational institution to take these services, counseling services. Okay. Then rehabilitation centers established by central government, state government, union territory, or maximum it has to be established by 12AA entity. Only those are allowed. If I'm a private sector company, I'm charging hefty fee, 2 lakh rupees for one consultancy. Then it is taxable because I'm not a charitable entity. Yes or no? Hello.
Yes.
All right. Only this provided by this entity. Very important because it was the latest amendment. I hope you understood this. Can I go ahead?
Yes.
Yeah. Some case laws and cases you need to read from your module. You can read from our module also. If you get any case, we will read. Okay. Listen. A small business entity is carrying on a business relating to consulting engineering services in Delhi. Small business entity. Okay, an aggregate turnover of entity does not exceed 20 lakh. If they take services from government, taxable or exempt? Small business entity, taxable or exempt?
Exempt,
because we don't want to put some compliance burden on their head. Okay, so services provided will be, no tax is payable. No tax is payable, you understand? Okay, because it is exempt. But if turnover exceeds 20 lakh, then it is taxable. Okay. Next. Karnataka Cricket Association, Bangalore, requests the Commissioner of Police, Bangalore to provide security in and around the cricket stadium for the purpose of conducting cricket match. You must have seen in cricket, apart from private sector security guards, even government police department will be there. Alright. The Commissioner of Police arranges the required security for agreed consideration. It's not free. They charge money for it. Okay. In this case, services of providing security by police personnel are not exempt. It's not exempt because it is not given to general public.
Yes.
It is given to business entity. It is given to business entity. As the services are provided by government, okay, government Karnataka Cricket Association is liable to pay. Yes. It's government, and then Karnataka Cricket is a service receiver, RCM. Okay, so that business entity need to pay tax.
Yes.
Same with this IPL matches and all. in IPL police are there.
Yes.
So the bodies who are taking the services will have to pay tax under reverse charge maker. Understood this?
Yes.
Next. Public Work Department of Karnataka, PWD department. PWD department, department which create this road, tunnels, dam and all. Enter into an agreement with Messrs. ABC Limited, a construction company. Okay, for a construction of his office complex for an agreed consideration. So they give contract to building some police building or some government building or mantralaya. Hello? Alright. In the agreement dated, it was agreed by the both party that Messrs. ABC shall complete the construction work and hand over the product before 31st December. Can you guess what is going to happen? Before 31st December, they were supposed to deliver. Obviously, they will not deliver on time. If they don't deliver on time, government will get angry. And they will charge penalty for it, tolerating for of non-performance. Just now we read, okay? It was further agreed that any breach of terms of a contract by either party would give right to another party to claim damages or penalty. Okay. Messrs. ABC did not complete the construction and did not hand over the project by 31st December. Okay. As per the contract, the department asked damages or penalty from ABC and threatened to go to the court if not paid. Resultantly, Messrs. ABC Limited paid amount of 10 lakh rupees to the department for non-performance of the contract. Yes or no? Should they pay GST on this?
No.
Answer is no, because tolerating non-performance was exempt in one of the entry. Yes or no?
Yes.
Alright. So amount paid by Messrs. ABC Limited to department is exempt. So this is how we have done government services. You understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'll pause. If you have any doubt, then ask.